if we are alone. And she is not that well taken care of. And was only in the last 3 or 4 miles of her life that his family called it hospice. And he didn't last much longer. He wasn't dead. Hospice was a good old age. Are they old? Not even old. Maybe because your mom thought, you know, I'm at that stage that I can't look in my wife's face, that my wife isn't able to do what she's always been doing for me. Who cares anymore? It's not worth it. My best times with Jemima and Obi was when I was visiting them and they had their little granddaughter with them. It was so enjoyable to me because they were of one generation, one school of thought, and she was of a different generation and a different school of thought. But they didn't complain. They did what they had to do and they did it with love. And this is not the way we operate today necessarily in America. We have a word in fact that's nani, which means I do it in spite of myself. I don't really want to do it, but I do it in spite of myself. That's not how they operated. They didn't do it in spite of themselves. They did it because it needed to be done, and they loved it, and at the funeral, who broke my heart was this little girl, crying so much for her sibling. Because she realized what he and her grandmother had done for her. They were there when they needed to be there. I salute you tonight, my four friends. You know, in the Middle East, you don't have too many poor people. You're one of them. I'm not. But Jamal's come along, God bless his soul, he was so poor. And whenever I come to talk to him, I had to raise my head like this to look up to him. Okay, you and I can talk one-on-one. But Jamal's come along, God bless him, he was poor. And even though I use expressions like smuggler, which is inherited, in the name of God. I did this one time with somebody, you know, you were talking in unity. You're talking like the person, the Arabic you're using is someone that's still alive. This is wrong. I said, no, this is right. That they are still alive. And they are with us. We don't have memorials just to make people feel good. We have a memorial to let the person who's gone on know that we're thinking of them. The Jamal is in our hearts. And all those people that have gone before, and I know that a living testament. You know, when you've been a priest in the same church that you've been for 43 years, you have lots of funerals. And I remember Jesus. I don't remember everybody that has been to the church. Even St. Paul said, I don't know if I baptized more than this or that one. I don't necessarily remember who I am, but I definitely remember who I married. And Jamal is a good man. And a loving father, and a loving husband, a loving brother, a loving uncle. But most of all, he was a loving son. Because he was there with his grandchild, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We'd like to ask at this time the believers to come and to participate in our love offering. We have had a very interesting summer. Many of you know our air conditioner has been on the Lent. I received the final bill today. For the repairs of the air conditioner, the total $10,050. That's not the kind of money that we're going to make. So we ask you to participate in the love offering.